most important thing when you're playing skills is not to play them too fast. If you're playing them, let's say, for an exam, the examiner is not looking for speed. The examiner would much prefer a steady scale, well played. Now, scales are very important from the point of view that they teach you keys, also they give your fingers exercise, and this is very important for playing pieces. I would recommend that you play scales every day. If you're a teacher, I would recommend that you maybe spend 5 or 10 minutes in every lesson doing some scales, so that scales are a part and parcel of playing the piano. In many ways, they're our calling card, a rite of passage, so to speak, that we might, we all have done scales, so we belong to this club. And if you haven't done your scales, well then, you're not a member of the club. And what I would say is, about scales again, is there's a lot of myths and fallacies about playing scales. The first thing is, when I was taught young, I was taught to, I'm going to show you this now, watch very carefully. It's to hold this note and join here. Now, in theory that sounds great, but the problem with that is, and with a lot of piano playing, is that the hand is now in the wrong position. The hand needs to move with the notes. So, you're never really going to get this perfect legato on the piano anyway. Unless you play very, very slowly and playing decrescendo, believe it or not. So forget that. And I'm going to give you a very simple tip. And the tip is how to control your thumb in scale playing. I almost would say, goes for us to say, is that when you think about playing the piano with your fingers, but don't play with your thumbs. The thumb does not work the same way as the fingers. So, simple exercise, country motion scale, C major. I learned this in New York many years ago. So you play, but you do not play the thumb. You place the thumb on the note in the time that you would normally play it, continuing playing the fingers. So it's very important that you don't overdo this fix. So I'll do it once more. You can play the first thumb. And you notice that my hand is moving level. You notice another thing that I don't do, and if you go onto YouTube and watch the great pianists, they don't do this either. You don't get this elbow. This is something that we were taught in Ireland years ago. Nobody does it. And the reason they do that is because they're trying to make legato scales. So,
on the piano at all times.